विष्णुपदाय गौरपृष्ठाय भूतले श्री श्रीमद्भक्ति प्रज्ञान केशव इतिहास अतिमात्र चरित्राय स्वाशितानंच पालिने जीव दुखे सदा काय नाम प्रेम प्रदाय वंशा कल्पतरुभ्यश्च कृपा सिंधुभ्यैव च पतितानां पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो महावदन्याय कृष्ण प्रेम प्रदायते कृष्णाय कृष्ण चैतन्य नाम्ने गौरद्विषे गुरवे गौरचंद्राय राधिकाय तदादि कृष्णाय कृष्ण भक्ताय तदभक्ताय तवैवास्मि न जीवामि त्वया विना इति विज्ञाय राधे तं न माम चरणं त्यजे। माय कोटि कोटि दंडोत प्रणाम इन द लोटस फीट ऑफ माय स्पिरिचुअल मास्टर ओम विष्णुपाद अष्टोत्तर श्रीमद् भक्ति प्रज्ञान के सोगुष्वा and same koti koti dandat pranam in the lotus feet of my shiksha guru nitya lila pravishta om vishnu bhav shri shrimad bhakti vedanta swami maharaj. Yesterday in my class I told you that remaining burden of earth Krishna wanted to remove before his departure from this world. So, he inspired Brahmins and Rishi, and they gave cause that very soon they will be finished. When all were finished, then Baladev Prabhu took samadhi and he left this world and entered in Aprakrit Golok Vrindavan. Krishna was as if nothing happened and he was sitting in a peepal tree. Thinking something, in the meantime, Uddhav came weeping and he told Krishna, now I have known that you are going to your Swadham, Golok Vrindavan. So please take me with you. Without you, I cannot remain here. So please take me. Then Krishna told, you will have to be in this world. I will tell you the essence of all the literatures. How a person can attain Supreme Lord, very easy. So, you should stay here and I am teaching you all these things. And after this, you should go to Badrikashram. There, Maitreya Rishi. In the way you will meet Vidu, you should tell him all these teachings. And then you should go to Maitreya and tell him, and he will reveal all these things to whole world. And I know that if you are here, no separation with me. Anyhow, you will be in Vrindavan, on Kusum Sarovar, as a blade of cross is there. Asa Maho Charna, Reni Jusam Aham Syam. He has prayed that I should be in Vrindavan as a blade of cross. Gopil, come to Avisar Krishna, their feet dust will be there and my life will be successful. So you should be there. After some time, Vajranav and Parikshit Maharaj will come to you. And then you should tell them all these things. So Krishna began to tell all these things. Up till now, what I told, it was preface. That in what circumstances Uddhava came and Krishna told him all the teachings. So now, first of all, we will discuss about Nemi Maharaj and Nava Yogendra. Once Vasudeva was with Krishna and whole dynasty. At that time Narada came and he washed his feet, took his feet water and gave it to whole family. And then he asked, in my previous birth, I have done aradhana that Supreme Lord should come as my son. But I have not done anything to be liberated from this world. So please tell me the easiest process that even a lame man who has heard nothing about this, he has no idea of what is Krishna consciousness, so easily they can follow and have the Krishna prema. So, it has told in Srimad Bhagavatam, Govinda Bhuja Guptayam, Dharavatta Puna Puna Kuradva Avishit Narada Avikno Krishna Darsana Lalasa. You know that Narada Rishi is highest class of Rasik devotee. In the first creation, Daksha Prajapati sent his so many thousands of sons to be educated in the school of Narada. Narada very soon trained them and they become sannyasi, renounce. And they went to forest to do aradhana of Krishna. When Daksha came, where are my sons? Still now, their study is not completed. Where they are? Oh, they went to their house. From school they have given them. What holiday? And then, he knew that, oh, Narada has trained them. They have become highest class of devotee. And they will never return to this world. what world is, Narad knows. Narad knows. Only fire and fire. In this world, anyone cannot be satisfied by worldly desire and sense gratifications. So, Daksha went to return back, and then again so many sons he sent to Narad and told him, oh, don't teach them all these things. You can teach them how to make praja, how to children and daughters and sons and daughters. So only teach them this. Oh, I will train. And then he trained, and they become also pure devotees. And they went to forest. Again he became angry, Daksha. Oh, again I warned you not to teach them this Harikatha, but you have trained. Now I am giving you course that you cannot stay anywhere to teach anyone. As soon as a cow is milked, oh, 5 minutes, you can stay there only. Not more than that. Thus you will. Narad told, oh, very good. Now I will teach all others. At first I was engaged in the service of only the sons of Daksha. Now in the whole world I will tour and I will teach my bhakti to all. So, Govinda Bhuja Guptayang Dharavatya Punah Kuru Dvaha. So, the Daksha Shah, that cause of Daksha, could not enter in Dwarka because it was rakshit by
protected by Krishna's arm.
Krishna. So when Narad Rishi used to come to be with Krishna, there he used to spend so many days and months. And again, Krishna used to send him, again he used to come. So, when Vasudev Maharaj told, I have done Aradhana of Supreme Lord, he should mention, I have not done anything for my liberation. Please tell me. Hearing this, Narad became very, very happy and told, you have remembered me, the sweet pastimes and aprakrit gunasamuha, qualities of Krishna. If anyone will hear, even one time, it will come in the ear of persons, they will be liberated, Krishna Prem will come. So, you have reminded me, now I am telling that in very ancient time, there was a king, name was Nemi Maharaj of Janakpuri. Very learned, and he was pure devotee. And in their kingdom, the son of Rishabhdev, now Jogendra, came. He was doing 5 sacrifices, thousands of Ritviks and others were there. When now Jogendra 9 came, all stood up. You know, Rishabh Dev, he has 100 sons. The eldest was Bharat Maharaj, and he was the king of Ajanab, Varsha, and by his name, it became Bharat Varsha. He was a great devotee. He left this world as a stool, and he was doing bhajan in the forest. And he reached up to Rati Avastha, Bhav, Sudarsatva. And then, anyhow, he was entangled with a baby deer. And he used to lump what he has left before. No? He had left his sons, daughter, wife, wealth, big kingdom, everything. But now was so much attached. So three births he lost. At the time of death, what he was doing?
Thinking about that baby.
Remembering, oh my dear son, very auspicious, where you used to travel, your feet dust, it was the place of fire sacrifices. And in the meantime, death come, and he remembered. So if anyone will attach to a beautiful lady, what will be result? If to deer attached, and he lost, and he was up to Bhavavastha, and then we of no place, or thousands and hundreds of lives, we will lose. Be careful. And then he became, reminding him, became what? Deer. So if we will attach too much to our family, ladies, wife, son, and at the death of that time, they must come in our remember, and we will be, oh, lady. Ladies will be male. So be careful. Now Jogendra, after three lives, he again received the same state, and he attended Krishna Prem and liberated. Now Jogendra, they were from beginning like Sanak Sanandan Sanatan Sanat Kumar. Paramahansa, no jati, no
caste,
nothing. They used to go everywhere where they like, in Swarga, heaven, up to Brahmalok, yet everywhere in the earth. So when he came, they came, all stood up. And Nemi Maharaj told, the fruit of all the yajna has come here. Now stop the yajna. No need of doing any sacrifice. And then he asked the same question. Same question. So, now we will begin 11th canto. When Narad came to Vasudev Maharaj, Vasudev told, Bhagavan bhavato jatra स्वस्तये सर्वदेहिनां कृपणानां यथा पित्र उत्तम श्लोक वर्तनं ओ नारद ऋषि यू आर ट्रेवलिंग टू दिस वर्ल्ड इज फॉर द बेनिफिट ऑफ होल वर्ल्ड यू आर सो मर्सीफुल मोर देन फादर एंड मदर भूतानां देवचरितम् इफ यू वर्शिप गॉड्स डेमी गॉड्स If you want poison, they will give poison. Even Shankar, he gave a bone to Bhasmasur, to whom you will keep your hands. Finish. So Indra, Varun, Yam, all, they will give what you bad intention want. They will never think that whether it is poison or It is nectar. Then
the name Maharaj being fire sacrifice, then Hota Udgata must be kept on Sasan.
So when from Nami Maharaj, when fire sacrifice was stopped, then Videhu Vacha, Nami Maharaj. मन्ने भगवतः साक्षात् पार्षदो बोध मधुदिश विष्णु भूतानि लोकानि पावनानि चरन्ति ही ओ आई थिंक मन्ने आई थिंक दैट यू आर पार्षद ऑफ मधुदिश कृष्ण सुप्रीम लॉर्ड दे ऑलवेज ट्रेवल इन होल वर्ल्ड आउट ऑफ मर्सी टू Teach them Bhagavad Dharma. Like at the time of Ajamil, Vishnu Dev came. They were going to travel in world, and they saw and told him so many things. And then he went to Haridwar and began to chant pure name of Narayan, and thus he achieved the prema and he goloked to. So Durlabho Manuso Deho Deha Tehinang Shanabhandura Tatrapi Durlabham Manne Baikuntha Priyadarshanam. Can you? You have not? You can take the book and I told you to be prepared.
I don't know which shloka.
Although you can see this shloka. You have noted. From tomorrow, you should note down all these things. Ekadasha Skand, second chapter, 29th shloka.
Durlabha manusho deho dehinam kshanabhangura tatrapi durlabham manye vaikuntha priyadarshanam. For the conditioned souls, the human body is most difficult to achieve, and it can be lost at any moment. But I think that even those who have achieved human life, they rarely gain the association of pure devotees who are dear to the Lord of Vaikuntha.
Explain something.
Om Ajnanati Mirandasya Jnananjana Shalakaya Chakshurun Militam Yena Tasmai Sri Gurave Namaha. So here, which Navi Yogendra is speaking? Or this is? This is still Nemi Maharaj. Nemi Maharaj was, as Srila Gurudev has described, he is now being visited by these by these Nava Yogendras, by these nine very powerful rishis, saints, who are pure devotees. So he's making the statement to them, as Srila Gurudev said, that he was performing this great sacrifice, and now that they have appeared, now he declared, oh, the purpose of our sacrifice is now fulfilled because these personalities have come. So he's explaining that this human birth, the opportunity for the jiva soul in this material world to get the human body is extremely rare. Why? Because in this material world, there are 8,400,000 different species of life that the jiva soul, the jivatma, has to travel through in order to come up gradually to the human platform. He has to travel through so many species of aquatic species in the ocean. He has to travel through so many species of reptiles on the land, so many insects. He has to come up through the bird species. He has to come up through the animal species. And finally, he comes to the human species. Even within human form, there are so many different types of human species, and half of them, out of 400,000 human species, 200,000, half of them, they're uncivilized. What is uncivilized? It means that they have no Vedic culture, no connection with the Absolute Truth. And so he has to travel through millions, literally millions of lifetimes, in order to attain one human birth. So Maharaj Nimi is declaring his own good fortune that this human form of life is so rarely attained. Now I have attained that human form of life. But within the human form of life, even more rare to attain is to actually meet face to face with a pure, unalloyed devotee of the Supreme Personality of Godhead. This is so inconceivably rare. There is an example that we have heard from our Srila A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, that he explained, there is a tortoise, just like the turtles, very big, large turtles, they go down into the ocean, and they dive quite deep, and they hold their breath. So after some time, again, they come back up to the surface. So when they come up to the surface, they get some more air, oxygen, and then after some time again, they go back down. So there is one tortoise, who is underneath the surface of the ocean. And on top of the surface of the ocean, there is a log, a piece of wood. It is floating along, and inside of the log, the piece of wood, there is a hole. So this tortoise is swimming upward, gradually coming up to the top of the surface of the water, and this log with the hole in it is also floating along. And for this tortoise to come up and meet at the very point where this log of wood floats across, and to put his mouth up through this hole, this is the rarity of coming into the human form of life and meeting a pure devotee of the Lord. So you can figure it out mathematically. So the point is that... Yes, he reminded that the tortoise, it comes up once only every 100 years. Yes. So, like this, actually, we are unaware of this fact. We are traveling in this material world for millions of lifetimes, and we are unaware of this fact of what we have gone through previously before receiving this human birth. But those who are enlightened souls, they understand that manushya durlabha janma, that the human form of life is very, very rare. It is only for one purpose, actually. It is for the purpose of spiritual cultivation and spiritual realization. But without coming in connection with saintly persons in the human form of life, it is actually not possible to advance spiritually. So Maharaj Nemi is proclaiming his good fortune that now on this very day, these great saintly persons have come before me and the purpose of my human form of life is fulfilled.
What? Dharman Bhagavatam. Authentic.
The next shlok.
Go on, do it.
Ato atyantikam kshemam prichamo bhavato naga saṃsāre smin kshanardho pi satsanga sevadhir nrinam. Therefore, O completely sinless ones, I ask you to kindly tell me what the supreme good is. After all, even half of a moment's association, spiritual life begins. Even if he had no connection with the pure devotion previously, but when he meets the pure devotee face to face, now the seed of devotion is planted in his heart. There are so many examples in Shastra. We have also heard the example of Sri Narada Muni meeting the hunter Mrgari. Very, very low grade persons. They had no life was completely transformed and changed. So therefore Maharaj Nemi is making this statement that even if one has the chance to get half of a moment of association in proper consciousness with such a pure Vaishnav personality, then he has the opportunity to attain the ultimate benefit, the atyantikam kshemam.
What is atyantikam kshemam?
So the ultimate benefit that a person can attain in this human form of life is prema pumarto mahan. As Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu has brought to this world this greatest gift of Krishna praying. Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, before he came to this world, there was also the opportunity to attain prema, to attain love for God, to attain Vaikuntha prema. But Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, in the present time, is the ultimate opportunity, the ultimate of the ultimate good for the human being. That one can attain Vraja prema, and within the context of Braja prema, one can attain the eternal association and service of the lotus feet of Radha and Krishna. So the human being is not meant only for dharma, artha, kama and moksha. These four goals of human life are insignificant in comparison with the ultimate attainment of prema. So the pure devotees of the Lord, they inform the human society about this ultimate good, ultimate attainment for them, and they set them on this path of pure devotion to the Supreme Lord so that one day they may attain this Krishna prema.
Also, more than that, extreme gopi prema, braj prema,
yes.
And then Radha-dasya.
Radha-dasya.
This is authentic, yes. Of supreme kalyan.
Auspiciousness.
Oh. After that, you. Hearing this question, Kavi began to answer. And he told that himself Krishna, Supreme Lord, has so many process of attaining him. Easiest thing. If he will run, closing your eyes, means what is the meaning? If you will neglect something, vidhi marga, no harm. By that, you will attain Braj prema, Krishna prema. And then he began to tell, kayena vasa, vacha, manasa indriyai va, buddhyatmana vanushit svabhavat, karoti jachat sakalam parashmai narayani iti sarva parashmai.
What number is that one?
It is not Prahlad Maharaj Upakhyan.
So, in accordance with the particular nature one has acquired in conditioned life, whatever one does with body, words, mind, senses, intelligence, or purified consciousness, one should offer to the Supreme, thinking this is for the pleasure of Lord Narayan. Next verse.
Meaning?
Gurave Gaura Chandaya Radhikaya Tadale Krishnaya Krishna Bhaktaya Tadabhaktaya Namo Namaha. Means this body that we have received is due to our past activities. Therefore, with whatever we have, our Prarabdha Karma, with which our present body is now made of, in whatever condition one finds oneself, one should engage one's body, mind, words, intelligence, and consciousness as an offering to the Supreme Lord. For example, this Bhagavad Dharma is so broad, one should not think, oh, this is only for human beings. Because we see even those in the lowest species of life who have achieved a body as a result of their past karma, they can also engage in Bhagavad Bhakti. Like Gajendra, Indrajuna Maharaj, because of his karma, his past activities, he was cursed by Angira Rishi to take the form of an elephant. Despite being an elephant, he could still engage in Bhagavad Bhakti. Or what to speak of devotees like Garuda, even despite assuming, of course it's an eternal parikha form, but even assuming the form of bird, he could still engage in Bhagavad Bhakti. Therefore this Bhagavad Bhakti, this chanting of the holy name can be performed in any condition. Atako Bhakti Vinod, he prayed, Kita jan mahau jata tura das bahir mukha brahma nahi mora as. He said, even as a result of my past activities, I have to take birth as a worm. Still, I want to take birth as a worm in the house of a devotee, so I can get the chance for a Sangha or Vaishnav. I don't want to be born even as Lord Brahma if I am born against you, without the chance of satsanga. Therefore, this Bhagavad, like Guru Maharaj was saying, even if one runs with eyes closed, there can be no fear of fall down. Even if there is some mistake in a devotee's performance of Shravan Kirtanam Vishnu Smaranam, there's no doubt he will achieve the supreme destination. As a result of his past activities, Valmiki took birth as the dacoit Ratnakar, but he chanted the holy name backwards. Still he achieved perfection. Ulta nama japati jagajani Valmiki bayo brahmana samani. Therefore there's no question of anyone falling on this path of bhakti. Even though Bharat Maharaj, he was degraded by his activities to take birth as a deer, still he could achieve the topmost destination. Even though Maharaj Chitraketu, as a result of his activities, he had to take birth as the Asura Britasura, still he achieved complete perfection. Therefore one should not think, oh, this present body is unfavorable for bhajan, oh, I was born in the West, oh, I have so many bad samskar. This Navagendra Sambhad says, whatever you have, in whatever condition, whatever time, place, circumstance, this bhakti has no obstacle. One can engage whatever one has, in whatever condition, in the service of the Lord and achieve complete perfection.
When did the other witness?
This was Pujapati Vigamaraj's favorite verse. Boyam dvitiya bhavanesa tasyadi sadvipasya vipariyo smiti tadmaya taya abhajet buddhatvam bhaktyaiki sham gurudevatmanaha. Gurudevatmanaha. Atma. So this was the question Nimi Maharaj asked, how can even a foolish person who has no knowledge, how they can cross this ocean of birth and death? So boyam dvitiya abhavanesa tasyad. So, viparya smriti, the living entity, because he has minute independence, and because of minute independence he's come to this world, he has developed viparya smriti, means a feeling of enviousness towards Krishna. Oh, why he should be the center of everything? Why he should be bhakta? Why he should be the enjoyer? I should be the enjoyer. I should be the center. Therefore, because of viparya smriti, because of enviousness of Krishna,
He falls to this world and immediately he experiences bhayam dvitiya abhavanesatashat. Immediately he experiences fear because he associates with, he is claiming something as his own. Pujapachivika Maharaj gave an example. For example, a brahmachari, he's alone doing bhajan and he's very happy. But as soon as he marries, immediately comes fear. Because he thinks she is mine. Then comes fear, what happens if someone else takes her? What happens if she becomes sick? Then the baby comes, then more fear comes. Oh, I have to supply for the baby, I have to do this, I have to do that. Because as soon as one thinks this is mine, immediately comes a situation of fear. For example, if we're walking down the road, we have no money, nischint, no problem. But if we have $10,000 in our pocket, then thinking, oh, everyone will rob me. Therefore, bhayam dvitiya. That feeling of dvitiya or dual mentality is the cause of fear. Therefore, this is called bhakti. This is called abhujat buddhatvam. This is called maya, or that which is not. Which is not, isn't it? You are not the enjoyer and nothing is yours. That is called maya. So maya produces that feeling of aham mamata, mamati. I am this body and this is mine. Therefore, what to do? Because we are all in this present situation. Therefore, there is only one medicine that even a most foolish person can adopt. Bhakti ki sham gurudevatmana. Gurudevatma. Bhakti ki sham. Ek sham. That means
Gurudevi is paramaradhya.
Gurudev is our most worshipful. And one should perform one-pointed devotion to him. That means Guru. Now at the present we're thinking, well, my Atma belongs to me. I am this Atma. I am independent. So one should, like one has the same. Now we are thinking, this Atma is, I belong to myself. This Atma is mine.
Here Atma means Priya.
So
Gurudev is my Priyatam. Knowing this, you should serve Gurudev. Don't disobey him. Otherwise, fall down. So, you should know that Gurudev is our most priyatam bandhu.
Most dear friend, worshipful.
And we should obey and serve him. And by that, we should serve always Radha Krishna Kanjuga. This is easiest method. If bhayam dvitiya, if you will forget Krishna, then you will have to be what? Too much asakti in this world. Oh, I am this body. Oh, old age will come and then I will die. You think that I will die. So bhayam. Oh, at the time of death we cannot take anything. And so many diseases, so many problems in this world. So bhaya. That is why you should know Gurudev, your parama bandhu. More than father, mother, and relative, and wife. And obey him, and worship him, and then do bhajan to Radha Krishna. Shrivan Subhadrani Rathangapani. Janmani Karmani Chijani Loke, Gitani Namani Tadatthakani Gayan Bilajyo Vichare Tasanga. Sajjan Maharaj Kayan. Then you. You prem
priyo jan. Omkar Tivarandasya Gyanandana Shalakya Chakshur Anuritam Dena Tasmai Sri Gurave Nama. Canto 11, text 39. Srinvansu badrani ratangapanir janmani karmani chayani loke gitani namani tadatakani gayan vilajjo vicharat asanga. An intelligent person who has controlled his mind and conquered fear should give up all attachment to material objects, such as wife, family, and nation, and should wander freely without any embarrassment, hearing, chanting the holy names of the Lord, the bearer of the chariot wheel. The holy names of Krishna are all auspicious because they describe his transcendental birth and activities which he performs within this world for the salvation of the conditioned souls. Thus, the holy names of the Lord are sung throughout the world. So, in this verse, it's explained that the having taken shelter of the lotus feet of Sadguru, as described earlier, one should, without any attachment, wander throughout this world. And
this
doing,
is the symptom of Mahabhagavat. So, a bhakta in Mahabhagavat, does like this.
So here, the symptoms of the Mahabhagavat in the stage of Prem have been described. What is he doing? Wandering here and there without any attachment. And vilajja means without any shame. He's not embarrassed or afraid to sing and dance. Why? Because he cannot see the people and society of this world. He's completely absorbed in his eternal identity and eternal relationship with Krishna. And what does he do? Srinvansu badrani ratangaparnya. He's hearing the beautiful, auspicious pastimes of Sri Krishna. Janmani karmani, about Krishna's birth and Krishna's activities. And chayani loke. Srila Vishnu Chakri Thakur said, chayani loke means he's describing, even in the languages of this world, in his local language. He may describe in English, French, Russian, Italian, whatever. He can speak the pastimes of the Lord. Who is the Lord? Ratangapane. Ratangapane means he whose hand has the mark of a chariot wheel. On Krishna's hand, he has so many symbols. The mark of a chariot wheel. So it's described when Akrura came to Vrindavan, then Krishna reached forward and went to touch him with his hand. And Akrura looked and saw the chariot wheel upon his hand, or the chakra on his hand. It's a sign that, oh my dear devotee, don't be afraid. I will protect you from all things. Gitani namani tadatakani. He should sing the names of Sri Krishna, like Govinda Damodara Madhaveti, Govinda Damodara Madhaveti, Govinda Damodara Madhaveti, Govinda Damodara Madhaveti, Tadartakani. And here, Tadartakani means he should explain the meanings. What is the meaning of Govinda? Govinda who plays with Go, the cows, who plays with Go, the gopis, who plays with Go means gopis, especially Shrimati Radhika. So he'll explain the meaning of all of these things. And in this way, or distribute auspiciousness throughout the world.
Vichareta Sangha?
I taught at the beginning.
In the last. Vichare dasanga.
Gayan means he will sing vilajjo without any embarrassment. And vicharet, he will wander here and there, asangaha, without becoming attached to any temporary material.
Without any attachment. No attachment. Only attachment to Guru and Krishna. So in this way, Mahabhagavat travels in the whole world to purify the whole world. Evam prata sapriya nama kritya jata anurago dacha chitta uccai hasat tatho rodati rauti gaya unamadyat nityati loka bahya. So evam prata
Vrata means Janmashtami Vrata and other Vrata. So our Vrata should be or to chant and to sing the glories of Krishna. Radhe 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 Jagadashi Radhe 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 Jagadashi Radhe 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 Jagadashi Radhe 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 Jagadashi Radhe Krishna Gopala Hare Mukunda Govinda Nanda Kishore Krishna
Sri Yashoda Tanaya Prasida Sri Vallabhi Ji Vanaradhikesha
Radhe
Radhe Radhe Jai 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 Sri Radhe
The names which are very favorable for you, you should chant. Like gopis used to do in their household activities also. If they were what, chanting
Govinda Dayamanave
make sleep for children. Oh, don't weep. You should sleep. Then not telling like that.
Govinda Dhamo Dharmada Veti Govinda Dhamo Dharmada Veti.
No shame. Oh, hands up like Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. And singing. Weeping, jato nuraga, at once Krishna Prem comes. He cannot change. Dutachitta uchai, loudly, he begins to chant.
Govinda Dhamo Dharmada Veti, Govinda Dhamo Dharmada Veti,
that Krishna is playing with all the boys, Madhumangal and all. Madhumangal told, if you will give your float, your dress, your peacock feather, no one will give anything to you. All laddu and everything they will give to me. Krishna told, oh, you should take. And he gave his peacock feather, pitambar, everything. And in the meantime, Keshi came. And he, with his behind legs, oh, he did like so. And then Madhumangal, then all began to laugh. Remembering this, and he began to laugh louder. Anyone laugh? The person, general person, they don't know why he is laughing. They think that he is mad person. But really what? Always remembering the sweet pastimes. Hasat. Oh, very loudly he begins to laugh.
ho, like.
Or sometimes he saw that Krishna disappeared. Then he began to weep louder. Why he is weeping? No one knows. Gayat unmadat, like mad person. And he sometimes nityati, to please Krishna, she dances. Oh, no shame at all, nothing. So these are the symptoms of a Mahabhagavata. We should try to follow. Don't be attached in anything, worldly things. It is very durlabh janma. Rare. Even demigods want to be human. Don't stand. Then he began to tell, bhakti pareshanu bhavo virakti ranetra. Can you try?
Trika trika eka kala. Prabhajamanashanatashanta shush tushti pushti shud apayono gasham. He's comparing the progress of devotion to the process of eating. That within every biteful, one experiences three things. Tushti pushti shuddha prano. That one gets pleasure from the taste of the food that he's taking. He also gets nourishment with every biteful. And gradually with every biteful, his hunger gradually diminishes. So similarly, bhakti prashana bhava bharaktir, he gets devotional ecstasies come. The seva vritti manifests in his heart. He wants to perform more and more devotional service. And also, he gets nourishment to his bhakti in the form of realizations. Direct experience in this process of devotional service comes. It's not this process of bhakti at this stage, it's not a dry process. There's direct experience. This is the progress after performing devotional service. And finally, virakti, or detachment from material activities, will gradually manifest as one gradually becomes, with every biteful, his hunger diminishes. So in this verse, he's explaining it. So similarly, we can use this in our daily activities of devotion to understand, how am I progressing? This is the barometer of our seva. If we're still having new material desires, hankerings for material activities, then there must be some lack, some loophole in our devotional service. So we should be attentive to these things.
After that slope, you. Ittachutangrim bhajato kutanya anuvitya.
Ityachu changrin bhajato anuvritya bhaktir viraktir bhagavat prabodha bhavantive bhagavatasya rajangs tata param shantim upeti sakshat. My dear king, the devotee who worships the lotus feet as the infallible personality of Godhead with constant endeavor thus achieves unflinching devotion, detachment, and experienced knowledge of the personality of Godhead. In this way, the successful devotee of the Lord achieve supreme spiritual peace. So this verse is very parallel to the previous verse where it says that just like when we eat, we get pleasure, nourishment, and relief from hunger. Here, by worshipping Krishna, one achieves unflinching devotion, detachment, and experienced knowledge of the Lord. In other words, by one's practice of devotional service, one progressively goes through the stages of the development between Shraddha and Prem, and gradually one becomes free from all anxieties, knowing, as we were hearing before from the previous verse, Bayan Vitya Binipshatasya, that fear is coming from misidentification with the body, and therefore possessiveness towards bodily relationship, and fear to lose those. So when one becomes free from that, one develops spiritual peace. In other words, he is not anymore affected by anything pertaining to the body, to the mind, and so-called possessiveness in this world, and then he is able to achieve that establishment in peace. He is completely engaged in Krishna's service, and he can directly experience Krishna, knowledge of Krishna. In the Bhagavatam, it's in the second chapter also we hear that one comes to the stage of realized knowledge of Krishna. He gets direct experience in this way.
Thank you. Here, anuvritya means with all time, one moment, what doing? By all senses, by mind, remembering the sweet pastimes of Krishna. By ear, hearing the sweet pastimes of Krishna. By mouth, singing the glories of Krishna and his name and other things. With hands, serving. With feet, traveling in the holy places of Vrindavan, Navadvip Dham and Neelachal Dham. So by all organs, you should utilize all our senses all the time, that Maya cannot enter in our heart. And thus, if you will do, then he is Bhagavat. And then that person will achieve eternal peace and also Krishna prema. Then, hearing this, the king again asked, Atha Bhagavatam Bruta Jadharmo Jadvisham Nidam. I want to know the symptom of Bhakta, Bhagavat. How they talk, how they behave. What they tell, I want to know. What is their nature? And with what symptoms he can be most dear to Krishna? I want to know. And then he began to tell, Sarbhuteshu jah pashye yu.
Ananyanatimidandhasya gyananjana salakaya chakshuronmilitam yena tasmai shri gurave namah. So now after that, till sarva bhuteshu ya pasyet bhagavad bhavam atmana bhutani bhagavatatmanesa bhagavatottamah uisuttam bhagavat sarva bhuteshu ya pasyet. Not only human beings, in all living entity he will see to whom? Yapasyad Bhagavad Bhavam Atmana. And which mood he has in his heart, he thinks all are serving my worshipable deity, my God, in same mood. If someone in mood of opulence, like Prahlad Maharaj, he thinks, all of this in this world, all are serving my worshipable deity, like is my same mood. And in this world, who came in Mahaprabhu's line, although all in Mahaprabhu's line, they are constitutional form of maid servants of Srimati Radhika, but some exceptional case also there. In summer Sakha mood, think, all are serving Krishna in Sakha Ras, in friendly term. With parental mood, like Mother Yashoda and Nanda Baba serving Krishna, always making you laugh. And sometime, Nanda Baba asking Krishna, can you bring my wooden shoes, please? Krishna became very happy, taking these shoes on his head and smilingly going to Nanda Baba. Who is in this parental mood, he thinks, all are serving my Prabhu in this parental mood. Especially in Sringar Ras, they are thinking, oh, all in this world, all living entity, serving my worshipful deity in Sringar Ras. So Bhagavad Bhavam Atmana, although all are not same mood, but is imposing them, oh, all are like this. Bhutani Bhagavatat Nesa, and in all living entity he saw his Prabhu. Although everybody's possibility is not same, although so many devotees are the disciple of same Guru, but their possibility is not same. Like Narad Rishi is Guru and Dhruva Maharaj is his disciple. His possibility is Narayan. Narad Rishi is Guru, Prahlad Maharaj is his disciple. His possibility is Nrisimhadev. Narad Rishi is Guru, Valmiki is disciple. His possibility is Lord Ramchandra. Narad Rishi is Guru, Vyasadev is disciple. His possibility is Sri Krishna. So, although in same Guru so many disciples, but all are same mood. So, Bhagavati Atman Nesa, and he is seeing all living, in all living entity, he is seeing his own Prabhu only, not others. Who like this, they are Bhagavatam, Uttam Bhagavat. They are not like Madhyam, Kanishtha or Madhyam, they are Uttam Bhagavat. So after that, we will listen more thing for the Lord of Sri Bhavshila Gurudev. Hare Krishna.
No, what?
Now, is defined by Srila Sukhdev Goswami, the symptom of Madhyam Adhikari. Ishare tadadhinesu balisesu disatsucha prema maitri kripapeksha ja karotisa madhyama. Ishare tad, he has four symptoms. Ishare tadadhinesu, Ishar means God, tadadhin means his devotee, balis means who is innocent, and disatsucha means envious to God or devotee. His four type of behavior. He has prema for God, and his devotee, Ishar Adhinesu, prema and maitri, he has maitri, means friendship with them. Maitri also different types. Maitri with maitri, friendship with friendship, and who is friend but junior to him. Friendship but prominent of mercy is there. And friend but senior, much more senior to him than with servitor mood, but friendship. These three types. Prema, Maitri, Kripa. Who is innocent or ignorant. Know nothing, but very simple hearted. He has merciful glance towards him. He wants always how to grace them, how to make them progress in Krishna consciousness. And who is against of devotee, deity, and devotion, very envious towards them, neglect them. So here, prema maitri kripa apreksha. Prem means after roti. When roti will come after that prem, like Hanuman is premi bhakta. If prem will come, then how will be madhyam bhakta? Not possible at all. But is mentioned in Bhagavatam. Is Bhagavat wrong? Not possible at all. We cannot think about in dream. So why in Srimad Bhagavatam is told prema maitri kripa apeksha? Means he is in bhav bhakti now. He is going to achieve bhav bhakti. So in the symptom of madhyam uttam, not achieve prem yet. As soon as he achieve prem, then he will uttam bhagavat, bhagavatottam. But not achieve prem yet, he is going to achieve bhav. It is mentioned by Srila Viswanatha Chakravarti Thakur, the commentary of this slok. So prema maitri kripa apeksha. And when in Uttam Bhagavat, he is traveling in this world, he is always absorbed in his mood. Although he is among with us, or previous also, he is doing so many activity. We think he is like a mortal like ourselves. Don't think so. Being with us, he is doing his own service, which is in its constitutional form. Like especially in Kali Yuga, when someone got perfection, his soul will be divided into two. One, they will serve Chaitanya Mahaprabhu being abode of Navadvip Dham, but by other, he will serve divine couple being in his the associate of divine couple. So is Bhagavatam being with us 24 hours a day serving same time simultaneously Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and divine couple. But we could not understand this thing. When will be qualified enough and his master his he'll bestow his mercy, then we can understand that thing not before that. So
Bolchi.
So here Prema Maitri, so Kripa Pekchayan, then you will be Premi Bhakta, then you will be Bhagavatam. And when this Uttam Bhakta traveling in this world, seeing somebody's miserable activity or miserable position, then his heart become melt. Karunaya Vidravan Deha. Then he bestow his mercy. Like Narada Rishi bestow his mercy to Nalkuvar Monikri and so many. So being in Bhagavatam, in absolute mood, he will not bestow his mercy. When he will see our sufferings and realize, then he bestow his mercy. And then he come down in Madhyam Adhikar. But he not losing his position. Being in Uttam Adhikar, because then Kanishtha Adhikar and Madhyam Adhikar already inside him. So being possessed in Madhyam Adhikar, then he bestow his mercy. Now after that, is mentioned in Srimad Bhagavatam, the symptom of Kanishtha Adhikar. Archayam eva haraye pujangya shraddhaye hate na tad bhaktesu channesu sa bhakta prakita smrita. Archayam eva haraye. What is doing? Archayam eva haraye. Is doing archana of hari. Whenever you take initiation, you have to learn two things. One is archana, another cooking. When we join mot, then Gurudev trained us two things. First, archan and cooking. Both have to learn. If you don't know cook, how to offer? And when you initiated, you have to offer. Without offering, how you can take your food? Then you have to learn cooking. So two things have to learn first. Then other thing. So archayam eva haraye pujang yo sraddhaye hate. And doing puja, but with Shraddha, not Paramarthi Shraddha has come properly. Pujayangya Shraddha yate. Na tad bhaktesu channesu. He has love for God, Shraddha for God, but not love or honor for his bhakta or devotee.
Or anna.
Or anna means other incarnation of God or other Vaishnavas. Then sabhakta prakita smrita. He called Prakid Bhakta, not a Prakid Bhakta. So, but when he is in this stage, but he is simple-hearted, Krame Krame Teha Bhukta Bhakta Haive Uttam, gradually by good association, he will learn all tattvas and will develop in his Krishna consciousness. Because he is simple-hearted, the Madhyam Adhikar will bestow their mercy to brought him up to in Krishna consciousness. So, who have taken initiation, they have to learn archan and cooking, then to other service, and gradually, when our Shraddha will grow up, then we can understand what is our duty, then we can honor his devotee more than God. If we do so, then Bhagavan will be more pleased, then gradually, we'll enter in Madhyam Adhikar. Hare Krishna. Pancha kalpata rupascha kripa sindhu bhaye vacha kritanam pavane.
जय जय राधा रमण हरि बोल जय जय राधा रमण हरि बोल जय जय राधा रमण Hari Bol.